Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope you guys are all doing really well. If you're new to my channel, then welcome. I do a lot of study, career, and personal finance type of videos here on my channel. So if that's something of interest to you, then please do subscribe by hitting the subscribe button down below. And also be sure to follow me on my Instagram as well. It is successbysanjna. I'll leave it up here for you guys to check out. But guys, as you can tell by the title of today's video, we are going to be talking about the Big Four, and I'm going to talk through some Big Four application tips. Now, this is all off the back of, you know, my experience working at the Big Four. I used to work at KPMG, and I just want to share with you because I know a lot of you guys have been messaging me as well. You guys are very stressed and very worried and don't know how to sort of proceed with the application or, you know, the entire recruitment process as well. So if that's something of interest to you, then please keep watching and let's just get started on today's video. Okay, so I just quickly wanted to talk about, you know, which applications or which Big Four applications are open at the moment. Before we begin, I just want to mention that I'm going to be talking specifically for Australia. I'm not entirely sure how this does work overseas. I think your intake is a little bit later in the year, but I'm going to be talking today specifically about Australia. Starting off in no particular order, I've just got my screen there, so I'm just going to be referring to that a little bit. Got PwC applications are open. They did open the 3rd of March and they are closing on the 29th of March. So I think you've got about 10 or so days to get your application in. I think 11 days to get your application in. So yeah, you still got some time. So yeah, just get started on your application, but I'll walk you through some of the tips a little bit later in the video. So we've also got KPMG. So their applications opened on the 22nd of February and they are opened until tomorrow. So you've got until tomorrow, you know, midnight to put your application through. So if you are considering or thinking about applying for the Big Four, then yeah, you better get started and you better, you know, get your application through ASAP. And I think this is also the case for EY as well. A lot of their applications do close tomorrow as well. And mind you, this is obviously all for the graduate recruitment program. Now, moving on to Deloitte. Unfortunately, Deloitte is closed and they seem to have started their applications a little bit earlier this year. And yeah, they have actually been closed. So look, if you missed out on Deloitte or if you think you're going to miss out on any of these other Big Fours, then don't worry, because intakes do open a little bit later in the year as well. And they do open around, you know, this August, September period. And honestly, that's when I got my job offer as well. I didn't get it through in the first round because I didn't think I was going to get it. And I didn't actually end up applying in the first round. So I applied in the second half of the year and I didn't even know that they were going to have it open in the second half of the year. So don't worry, because there are always, you know, options available. For now, we're going to talk through some of the application tips, some, you know, things that you should keep an eye out for and some things you should do to really sort of build your prospects and really gain your chances or increase your chances of getting through and potentially getting the job. So I've got 5 tips for you to make sure that your application stands out from the crowd. And from the crowd, I mean tens of thousands of applicants, because there's a lot of people applying for it. And, you know, given a lot of people that have, you know, lost their jobs, there's going to be a lot of competition in the recruitment process, the application process. A lot of people will be applying. Starting off with the first one, that is around your CV. This is obviously the first step in getting your foot through the door. So you want your CV to be as clean, concise, and relevant as possible. You want your CV to be minimalistic. You don't want the reader to pick up your CV and be like, oh, this just looks so confusing. I don't even want to go through it. You want to have, you know, very concise, simple, basic points. You want your CV to have a bit of a flow as well. I will link my you know, CV video that I did do. It is about the don'ts of you know, a CV, or the CV mistakes that you should not do on your, you know, obviously your CV. So I will leave that up here for you guys and also in the description box below. But essentially, you want your CV to be as interesting as possible. You want your CV to stand out amongst, you know, all of the crowd, and you want it to look professional, clean, you know, no grammatical errors, no punctuation errors. very relevant as well. You don't want information on there that is very outdated. Like for example, if you are, you know, in university, which I think you would have to be because you're applying for a graduate position, don't have your high school experience on there or your high school grades or what you did in high school on there, because that's no longer relevant anymore. You have things that you've achieved at university, so include those instead. All right, now moving on to the next tip, and this is when you're applying for your job and you're a little unsure about, you know, what the job actually entails, I suggest reaching out to people on LinkedIn. This is very important. I've suggested this to a lot of people, you know, that I've spoken to before as well, and I suggest speaking to someone on LinkedIn, someone that's already in that role that you are applying for. This will make it 10 times easier for you. You won't have that, you know, that burning feeling or, you know, that curiosity as to, you know, whether this is the right job for you or not. Try to find someone that's already working there, do a bit of a, you know, stalk and email or message that person. And don't just message one person, but be sure to message a few people, because you don't want to put your eggs all in one basket in case that person doesn't actually respond. So message or email a few people and see what they say about the role. You can ask them about really anything, you know, what their day-to-day activities look like. And if you've got the name of maybe your potential interviewer, maybe asking them as well, what is that interviewer like? You know, what's their personality like? And what are some of the do's and don'ts that you maybe suggest as part of the application or the interview process? So don't be afraid, you've got nothing to lose. And I know it's a bit of, you know, cold calling and just messaging someone random, but I mean, you've got nothing to lose. You need to do this for yourself, so don't worry about that. Number three, now, obviously we all know if you're applying for a Big Four job, there's a lot of numerical and logical tests there, which you do need to pass. These tests are obviously, you know, difficult. They're time sensitive and you are under a lot of pressure to get that done. They're not your generic sort of, you know, maths and English sort of, you know, scenarios. They are very sort of pattern based, very sort of very different questions. So if you do want to get some help on this and you do want to practice this beforehand, then there are a lot of websites online. Even if you just type in numerical tests examples online, a lot of them are sort of paid as well. But I do suggest if you are looking to get into the Big Four seriously and you want to make sure that you get this job and you do stand out, then paying for it might not be a bad idea. I didn't pay for it because I didn't want to spend the money. But you know, if you want to really get through and you want to pay for something like this, then definitely go ahead and do it, because there are a lot of examples, a lot of questions out there which you can practice and do daily as well. So I suggest looking online and looking at something that is maybe a paid version as well. If not, then you know, you just keep applying for jobs, and if you don't get through the first year, then you can try again the next year as well, and you've got experience, you know, seeing what those tests actually look like, of course, if you do get to that stage. All right, now moving on to the fourth tip that I have for you, and I think this is one of the biggest tips, and that is knowing what you've written on your CV and knowing your experience inside out. This is very important. This is crucial. You need to understand what it is that you're good at, what it is that you're bad at, but of course we're not going to mention that in the interview. But you need to talk like you are perfect and you are made for the job. You need to know your experiences inside out, just so that, you know, if they do ask a question about one of the experiences on your CV, you've got an answer, and you've got an answer which is structured in the staff format. Now, the staff format, I'm sure you've all heard about before. It is worldwide known, and it's just a way of answering your questions in a very structured way. So basically, you talk about the situation, and then you start talking about, you know, your task, your actions, or your, you know, your analysis, and then you talk about the result or the outcomes. And one other thing I actually like talking about at the end, so having it as stars, not star, is your self-reflection as to maybe what you could have done better in that time, or you know, that experience that you did have. So what I suggest, so now that you know what the star model is, in case you didn't know what that was before, I suggest breaking down your CV, having, you know, opening up an Excel spreadsheet and writing down all of your experiences, all of the possible sort of questions that the interviewer can ask you, and answer them on that Excel. So for example, if it's an experience or behavioral based question, you want to be able to answer it in that star format. So pick out maybe, you know, one of your experiences, a time where you did such and such. Maybe it's a customer service type role and you dealt with maybe an angry customer. That's always a typical sort of question. Write down what the situation was. What was the task? What was the action? And, you know, what were the results as well? And if that scenario didn't go well for you, then what was something that you self-reflected on and you did better for next time. So yeah, definitely suggest, mapping all of these scenarios out. It'll be helpful for you in case, the interviewer does ask you, tell me a time where you did this. You've got the experience or the situation mapped out instantly, then you can apply that STAR model and this will make your life so much more easier. Now, the final tip that I want to mention is that say you've gone through the application process and you are unsuccessful and you've been rejected. Don't take it too personally. There are a lot of applicants that are applying and there's only a couple of positions which are available. Don't beat yourself up about it because it's not the end of the day. You can apply elsewhere as well. And to be honest, it's just good feedback, a good learning curve for you because you may not be up to scratch on what they're really looking for. Or maybe your values and their values don't align. And in that case, it just might be better for you long term to not even have that job in the first place. So don't beat yourself up about it. Take it as, constructive feedback. I suggest going back to the recruiter, going back to the employer if you can and asking for feedback, asking and getting some good information as to what it is that you didn't do and what was something else that you could have done to, really land that job. And at the end of the day, it's a rejection. It's okay. Just keep applying for other jobs in the field that you want, and you will get there. So that is it, guys. Those are a few tips that I wanted to mention in today's video. If you've got any questions at all, or you're struggling with, what to do next, or, you just need help with the recruitment process, then be sure to just email me. I'll leave my email here on the screen. It's also in the description box as well below, and just email me. I'm more than happy to help you out. But that's it, guys. I wish you all the best if you are looking to apply. Do let me know if you do get the job. I'd love to hear about your success stories, and I will catch you guys in my next video. Thanks, guys.